75 pounds right here, and we're going to start at 80 pounds. We got Caden Call from Craig Middle School going against Daniel Karen of Rifle. 80 pounds championship match right here on MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM. Hey, if you like what you see, just remember, fans, to like us on Facebook. I'm here with Shane. Shane, you did a great job announcing all day at the middle school tournament. We want to say thank you also to all the people that make this happen. So many people, from scorers, tables workers, to mat helpers, to rolling out the mats, to putting up the mats, to trash, to the hospitality room, and the list goes on and on and on. And it really does take a village to get it done for our kids, and we did. What a great event, and it's been awesome, and we appreciate it. So remember to like us on Facebook, and make sure you subscribe to the MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM YouTube channel, and you will always be the first to get the latest videos covering our kids and our community, letting everybody know that you're Moffat County proud. All right, so underway in this match, and finding ourselves in a little bit of trouble there, hooked up in the cradle.
Yeah, right now, Caden Cole, he's had a great tournament today to wrestle to this championship point. Right now, he's behind in this tournament, but we are going to bring you all these championship matches in their entirety. And there he stands up off the bottom, down 5-0 early in this match. But he gets one escape here with 10 seconds left in the match. Final seconds here. So early on, Caden had just glitched a little bit there, got taken onto his back, but he fought back from that. And now the score is 5-1, and we're going to have the coin toss. It's going to be a deferral, and the decision is going to go over to Moffat County, who chooses down. Coming up off the bottom, doing a great job. Gets another point for an escape. That's big in this match now, trying to come back from that 5-1 deficit. And I'll turn this back over to Kip for a second. Now they have the score 5-4. He's got him on his back now, Kip.
Three-quarter stack, I love it. Keep it in tight, keep it in tight. Oh, and he's able to wiggle his way out of it, but not all the way. He sucks it back in.
Got him, Kip.
Oh, it's so close.
I think good luck when I say I'm going to turn it over to you. Look what happens. You call for a minute.
See if Caden can finish it.
And I'll be right back.
5-4, but he's got points coming with 47 seconds on the clock. Period 2. 7-5 lead for Call. Caden coming right back, switches off now, comes back on top. And he's going to get more back points here. Working hard for a pin. And he gets it. You hear the crowd. After being down early, Caden Call comes fighting back hard, and he's going to be your champion at 80 pounds. First champion crown of the day for Craig Middle School.
What a fantastic comeback, right? We were talking about thanking everybody. We looked over, down 5-0, and that is why they play the game, Kip. It didn't matter. Big comeback by Call, and he gets the pin and a rousing victory here in this fantastic environment here at our CMS wrestling tournament. As you said, so many of us so involved in this tournament, and it's been a blast. And now we'll go ahead, we will take a break for a second, and we'll be right back here on MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM.
All right, Shane, now we're up at 90 pounds. Championship match, Dylan Zimmerman, Craig Middle School Bulldog, going against Tyler Campbell for the Hayden Tigers.
It's a family affair here, Kip. His dad was an outstanding wrestler at our high school, then went on to college. Now his brother is a great wrestler at the high school level, just came back from the state tournament. And now we have younger brother, Dylan Zimmerman, wrestling for a championship here at our middle school tournament. There is a nice shot, single to a double, and he puts him down hard enough, but not too hard. Has him flat on his back. Let's see if we can get the pin.
Oh. Nice bridge by Campbell, able to come up to a stand-up, but not before he's given away some back points. 4-0 lead for Zimmerman.
Just like that, the beautiful shot turns a single into a double leg. puts him down nicely, gets back points, and has built himself a nice early 4-0 lead. Now he trips from behind. The official is Stelios Proulos, a third placer last year for our Bulldogs, graduated this last year, and still 4-0 with 29 seconds left. And you enjoy that when you're that wrestler who builds that lead early. Not that you're going to put it on cruise control, but you're a little less apt to do things that are shaky.
Dylan doing a great job with 15 seconds left, really controlling the match so far. Goes to the three-quarter stack, trying to put it on. And gets it. And it's going to be close. Pin with 2 seconds on the clock. Dylan Zimmerman, your champion at 90 pounds. Now, I'm going to give it up to Dylan right here. Dylan, I want you to know, I'm good friends with Dylan and his parents. And Dylan, I want you to know that I talked to them earlier, and I wrestled 90 pounds when I was a seventh grader. So Dylan, you and I, next weekend, we're wrestling, me and you, because I was 90 pounds as a seventh grader.
I told him the secret is to just run in a circle for 4 minutes solid. And you'll be so tired, he'll
kill. It will. I'll collapse. No, I don't think I'd want to wrestle Dylan right now. He's scrappy.
Yes,
great
sir.
Match for him, and he's your champion at 90 pounds. So we got two matches coming up right now. They're going to go at the same time. We're going to be swinging the camera back and forth. I got Ryan Duzik, 95 pounds, wrestling Jacob Murphy from West Grand. And Ryan's in on a nice double leg. Quick takedown, two, and they go out of bounds. And we're going to go over to Shane over with Anthony Duran.
Okay, Anthony Duran with a nice takedown. Did a shuck by. He almost fell down to his knee, almost went to his back, but he was able to shuck his opponent by for a really nice takedown. But now he's turned, and he might be in trouble, Kip. He's going to go over to his back, and he's going to roll out of it. So it's still 2-0, now 2-2. Let's switch back over.
All right, back over. Ryan Duzik still up 2-0. Able to put on the legs. Turns the
bring it back to me, Kip. We got a man on his back over here. Duran switched him over, put him on his back. Hopefully we get the pin here. We can switch back over to our other match. Do it to it one time is tough, but we'll do it for you. Get that pin, Duran, right now. Get the pin over here. We'll stick on this one, and there it is. There's the pin for Duran. Now back to your match, Kipper. What a great job for Anthony Duran.
All right, Anthony Duran picks up the win by pin. And back over to Duzik, up 4-2 right now. Against the West Grand wrestler.
That was good luck right there, Kip, for us doing back-to-back matches. Let's get another win here. But we're in a little bit of trouble here as giving up a reversal, but we're up 6-4. Great match again by Duran. Let's get this win over here too and keep the ball rolling.
Yeah, Ryan Duzik wrestling tough, comes up with a nice stand-up, and as soon as he stands up, right back in on the double leg, love it. That's what you do, that's how you get it done quick. Didn't waste any time. Knew that his opponent was vulnerable as soon as he stood up. Beautiful double leg, gets the takedown, and all, just like that, it's 10-4 with Duzik in the lead.
Two really good wrestlers right here. You can see already a very high skill set as they go back and forth looking for maneuvers here. That was a great takedown to end that period, and it gave us back. Now they've got the score 10-4, fantastic. Gives us that 6-point lead, and any lead bigger than 5 at this level of wrestling on into high school is huge because you can't be beaten with a throw to your back, only a pin. There's another nice single leg, and it's going to lead to another nice takedown.
Music getting the job done on his feet right now. Granby roll attempt by West Grand, countered well by Duzik. Puts the far half in, has the near ankle wrapped up. Now he's getting some back points.
Wow, that was an awkward position he had his man in. Now look at this, he's got him flat on his back.
Puts in a near side cradle, has that leg kind of trapped in there. Want to kind of, and he'll keep it hooked. And more back points coming, and maybe even a pin.
He
with
is.
These three
there
near fall, he'll push it to 15 if he doesn't pick up the pin right here. Duzik's got it hooked up tight.
What a fantastic start for these Bulldogs. And is his arm in the way there, Kip? Can he get the pin?
Yeah, hard to tell from this angle right here, but it's definitely close. 30 seconds on the clock. Trying to seal the deal right here.
He's literally right now just willing his opponent to his back. Has to try to kind of put him right on there and just lean into it. But his arm is in the way. Not sure if he's going to be able to pick up the pin with this move. But he gained a lot of points, and there it is. I knew if I said that, they'd give him the pin.
And it works every time. Works every time. Right on. Ryan Duzik with a big win. And that's at 95 pounds. He's your champion here at the Craig Middle School Bulldog Tournament.
You lead us in.
All right, we're back at 105 pounds. It's Blake Jurgens for Craig Middle School Bulldogs going against Peyton Planansky of the Hayden Tigers. Here's Shane with the call.
Here we go, a nice single leg. Just looking to finish it right now, and there it is. Pulls his head out, gains control from the backside. There's your first 2 points. And so far, our Bulldogs doing an outstanding job of the offensive maneuvers in the first period. And right there, trying to tilt his man over to his back. That is a strength maneuver in middle school. And there he goes. He's working that tilt. I mean, they call it a cheap tilt, but I just hate the way that sounds. The only reason they say that is because it's points that seem cheap, because you can't pin a guy with the tilt, but you can certainly build up a ton of points by turning them, releasing it, turning them again. So still 2-0, 30 seconds left here in the first period, and a good start for Blake Jurgens of our CMS Bulldogs. Last I checked, our Bulldogs were leading the team point. There he is, he turns him over. As I try to shift gears into something else, he's got 18 seconds to try to get this pin. A full day of sports. You got our wrestlers going right now. You also have our Lady Bulldog basketball players playing for a regional championship right now in Grand Junction. And time is going to run out in this first period, but he's going to get big back points also. And it's going to be 5-0 at the end of the first period.
Jurgens getting it done right now. Blake wants that gold medal. And if he keeps wrestling the way he is right now, he'll definitely be walking home with it around his neck.
So here we go. Here's going to be our decision. The wrestlers are going to be on their feet. And we're underway, second period. As you said earlier, what a well-run tournament. It went so smoothly using that track wrestling program and being able to announce every single kid as they came up. And you just gotta love the way the community, as you said, it takes a village. The community came together and has done a great job, and it'll only get better over the years using that new track wrestling program. And now we get to have the blessing, the pleasure of being up here calling these championship matches for these young men. And right now we have a 5-0 lead, and time now is the enemy of our opponent. But there it is, a beautiful double leg. Just needs to switch over, now climb the tree of woe, and there it is, 2-point takedown.
Yeah, textbook double leg, getting it done on your feet. Feet so important as these guys get older and into high school. There are so many matches that are decided by who gets the takedown, and they end up figuring out how critical it is. A lot of matches are won because of one takedown.
You know, they say a wrestler who can score on his feet is hard to beat, and that is true. You see so many instances now of a wrestler ahead late in a match, and instead of stalling, they had that one last shot in to get a takedown that seals the victory. So if you have a great shot or shots, you are going to win a lot of matches. And now 7-0 on the strength of that one brilliant takedown with 4 seconds left. And we're going to head to the third period with a 7-0 lead. And I started there earlier. The Bulldogs were ahead in the team points. Looking good, but you see so much talent over here in this Western Slope and with the teams that have come to this tournament. A big 9 teams came to this tournament, a big turnout. And there we go, Blake off the bottom, turns out, tries to work a switch and gets a nice escape to turn and face his opponent. And there's one.
8-0 lead for Blake with a minute 12 on the clock. Wrestle smart here. Here's where you don't want to do anything to get yourself caught on your back. If you are going to get taken down, you definitely don't want to fight it to the point where you put yourself in a precarious position. If you have to give that up, then give up the 2 points if that happens. Just wrestle smart. Blake says, no, I'll just get 2 of my own. And it's a takedown for him. 10-0 lead, under a minute to go.
Just goes in and takes that takedown. And as we said, builds it to 10-0. We've got a match going over here. Kip, if you want to keep an eye over here, let me know who's wrestling. Oh, but now look, Blake puts him on his back. Maybe he's just going to end it now, get the pin. and allow us to switch right over to our other match here. Has him tight, 31 seconds, 10-0. That match is just starting over there. Why don't you go ahead, if you want to switch the camera over, Kip, you start this one, and I'll keep an eye, tell you when there's a pin.
We might get a pin over there, we'll see.
We'll wait for the pin then. Let's see if we can get this pin. There it is. There's going to be a pin right there. Oh, but he pulls out, fighting for it. 10 seconds left. Nothing going on over here yet. You're right. Stick with it. Now we can switch over. It's going to end 13-0, almost the technical fall. There's a big win for Juergens. And we will switch right over to...
On the other mat, it's Joe Neal at 120 pounds for Craig Middle School, wrestling Kelton Turner of Meeker. So Turner from Meeker gets the takedown early in this first period, and it's a 2-0 lead for Meeker.
And let's be honest, we know one thing about Meeker wrestling. If your last name is Turner, you're probably really good.
Yeah, Kelton Turner's older brother took second this year. He was the runner-up, I believe, at 170 pounds. Lost a heartbreaker 1-0 match. He was the defending state champ. One of the things, though, is he battled a lot of shoulder injuries this year still made it to the state championship and almost won it. So they've done a tremendous job and definitely known in the wrestling community. Joe Neal fighting hard right now, down 2-0. And Neal giving Turner everything that he's got.
Well, and you know what? You've got to get to the championship to have an opportunity to win it. And right here, he hung in there. He's only down 2-0 at the end of that first period. And Turner had just been crushing everyone so far. So already, he's gone further than anyone else with Turner. He just takes one good shot like that, Kip.
There you go. Nice single leg by Neal. See if he can finish it. Tries to walk it around. Countered hard by Turner. Now he'll reach all the way across. Hard crossface by Turner. Trying to break free. And neither wrestler really where they want to be right now. This is where you might pick up a stalemate and they'll bring it back and start it again.
Yeah, at this point, still in there. Moffat County kind of getting choked off here now. This is where you hope for the stalemate to be called. Nothing going on. Push him out of bounds. Good call there. And
out of bounds they go, and they'll come back to the middle. I like the shot by Joe Neal. Good job there. That's what you got to do. Force the action. Keep yourself out of trouble. Take smart shots.
So back to the center they go with 44 seconds left in the second period. Only a 2-0 deficit. And again, Neal shoots in, but he wasn't able to get it on the leg that time. Yeah, he's going to kick
hard crossface by Turner to counter. Neal still holding on to that leg. Down to 20 seconds. And Turner's going to spin around and pick up two. Neal with a nice sit-out. Sits out again. But Turner counters well and able to follow.
Two really strong young men here. And you can see Neal is giving everything he wants to Turner. Turner realizes right now he's in a heck of a match. And shoot, if not for that last second give up with that takedown, still it's only 4-0. Anybody's ball game. You stay within five, you have a chance.
And going to be Meeker's choice. And Meeker takes top. And Joe Neal, quick sit out, turns, faces. Nice job. See if he can come out and get his one. Here's where you want to break away. At least get your one here. Don't let him back behind you.
Put all the, oh, and the shuck by, but he turns it into a double.
No points awarded yet. Call that the old-time cow catcher, double under there in the front.
Got to get away from this. This is trouble. So you want to walk into it or shuck yourself away, push his arms to the left or right, and step up and out. At least get your point.
Yeah, and right here, you're eating up a lot of clock, and you're in a really tough spot to get in on any kind of a takedown. So if you can break away here, just break away and get yourself a point. Hard front half now, and gets one count. Hasn't got another count yet, but close to giving up some points. Just a front half by Turner, and now Turner swings back around and able to counter that. And so all that work, and you really wanted to see Joe say, hey, just push away, get your point. Turner comes back on top. It's still 4-0.
Yeah, but Turner was able to kill all that time, and it just was one of those deals where he wrestled great, but not able to come up off the bottom. And they'll tell him at the end of this match, push him away, shuck left or right, get that point. And at that point, it would be 4-1, and who knows what can happen. But Turner definitely, yeah, it looks like a stalemate at some point here. Turner knows that he was in a match.
That's going to end it. 4-0, but a good match by Joe Neal. He wrestled really tough, like the way that Joe wrestles. Always aggressive, and he wrestles with a lot of heart. Loses a tough one. 4-0. He's your runner-up at 120 pounds.
Here we go. We're right into another championship match, Kip.
125 pounds. It's Michael Voloshin, Moffat County Bulldogs, Craig Middle School, against Cody Logan for the Sirocco Rams.
Got another one of these family affairs. His father is a coach at the high school and middle school, was a fantastic high school wrestler, an incredible wrestler at the University of Wyoming.
Still has some of the records there for, I believe, Near Falls, which is pretty incredible at a D1 school, and Wyoming always with well represented in the national tournament.
And now his young son here, coming into this championship, but some trouble right there. He's caught. He's going to have to turn this into a takedown as he has his own leg caught in a cradle position. No points yet, but his opponent doing a good job of forcing him down, grabbing the leg, and now he's going to give up. Not yet, but there it is. He gives up two. So now he's going to have to come up. He was involved in one heck of a match in the semis that I watched. He was behind, I believe, 5-6-0. Came back to win it 7-6. And it was awesome for him to get to this point. And now he's down 2-0 with 17 seconds left. And he's against Cody Logan from Sirocco. Sirocco having a good showing here, as they always do. We'll keep an eye on both, Kip. If you want to stay over here with Voloshin.
And I think this is
our big man.
198 on the other match. That's going to be Alex Reno. And he's wrestling Jordan Rowald of East Grand.
So we're at the end of the period there. Oh,
and he's got gives up a big double leg, and he's in where you don't want to be looking at the lights.
Yeah, it's trouble.
Reno fighting hard, trying to come off his back, but that's he's got over a minute to fight there. That's tough. Not going to be able to do it, and Reno is going to end up as your runner-up at 198 pounds. Still, great tournament for Alex Reno.
And I'll tell you what, earlier he had a match. He was down by 7-8 points. He came back and got the pin. So fantastic tournament for Reno. No reason to be ashamed of that second place. We're back over here now to Voloshin, where it's 4-0. Minute five. What are we in the third period there, Kipper?
I think we're in the second, but I could be wrong. That's too far for me to see that clock.
It would be the first time you've been wrong that I've known you, but
that's right.
Sometimes things happen. So 50 seconds remaining in this period, 4-0, and this is a good wrestling match, but a really good wrestler from Sirocco right now as he is pushing Voloshin to his limit, trying to put the legs in now, just keeping Voloshin on the bottom, not allowing him to get up off the bottom at all.
Under 30 seconds. There we go. Voloshin comes out, able to grab the ankle, and we're in a scramble position. Can he come out and get himself some points?
Huge.
Oh, isn't able to find a way out of it. That's just a scramble position. Both guys just jostling to see if they could get somewhere where they want to be.
And it got almost him on his like, back?
Almost come back. Yeah, look for a defensive pin here. Just tip back into him. If he can come around, if he get to, oh, he's not going to be able to make it there.
Whoa.
It's countered by the Rams. 4-0. As we come into the final period.
Here we go, we're on the last match of the night. Oh, and he shoots in, and Sirocco's too fast, but he falls and he's able to grab. He just needs to hold on to those legs, Skip.
Yeah, just crawl up now.
Back points. Telling you, as soon as he tilts
him,
there it is.
And he just cut the lead in half, 4-2. And Voloshin goes right to trying to put that leg in. And comes back, has the arm behind if he can hook it up. Oh, but he's slipping off. Got to be careful when you slip off there. Now he's able to work back up.
My goodness, do you see visions of his father there with the way he puts those legs in? His dad was a snake when it came to that. You couldn't shake him off, and he's got it, Kip. He's got 48 seconds here. to work this, either the power half, which he's doing now, or the guillotine, but he's got the legs in really good. And there it is.
Oh, he's so close to getting some back points. He gets one count right there. Pull it back, scissor the body. Can he hold it? He's got 2 points coming. That'll tie it up, but he's in a tough spot. He's got to crawl back over. You don't want to give up the reversal here. Back points, but he gets caught coming off.
What a fantastic effort, though. He had the legs in on a much bigger, older wrestler, and he was able to put the fear in him right there, made it 4-4. But then he gives up the last second reversal, and he's on his back. But my goodness, what can you say about that young man in that match? He knows that he could have won, and he's not going to, but it was back and forth, and it was fantastic. What a great day for that young man, too.
All right, Michael Voloshin ends up as your runner-up at 125 pounds. Thanks for being with us right here on MOFFATCOUNTYPROUD.COM. And your champion at 75 pounds, Brody Weiser, Craig Middle School Bulldogs. First place for Craig Middle School at 80 pounds, Caden Call. Prince for Craig Middle School at 85 pounds, Colton Jones. Fourth place at 90 pounds for Craig Middle School was Keenan Hampton, and your champion, Dylan Zimmerman. From Craig Middle School, your champion at 95 pounds is Ryan Duzik. Your champion at 100 pounds from Craig Middle School, Anthony Duran. 105 pounds in third place for Craig Middle School, Isaac Ballum. And your champion from Craig Middle School, Blake Jurgens. At 115 pounds, Craig Middle School placers are in fourth place, Ethan Hapey. And in third place, Billy Lockyer. Placers for Craig Middle School at 120 pounds. In third place, Colton Terry. And runner-up, Joe Neal. In second place at 125 pounds from Craig Middle School, Michael Voloshin. At 130 pounds in third place from Craig Middle School, Brock Harton. At 135 pounds in fifth place for Craig Middle School, Logan Hapey. At 152 pounds in third place from Craig Middle School, Daniel Cruz. And in second place, Tanner Musser. 171 pounds from Craig Middle School in third place, Corey Scranton. 198 pounds from Craig Middle School, your runner-up, Alex Reno. Steamboat Springs Sailors, third place with 214 points. Second place with 273 points, the Meeker Cowboys. And in first place with 363 points, your Craig Middle School Bulldogs.